usual jokes, Master. You know, the ones that are always good for a laugh.
Well, go ahead, any of them.
Oh, what a day!
Except what a day. Don't give us that one. It's gone awfully sour.
But something witty like.
Oh, yes, anything.
Oh, my poor back.
Except my poor back.
Can I tell them the really funny one?
Oh, yes, do. Please do.
Oh, somebody better unload.
Oh, wait, don't say this one.
Don't say what?
Don't ship your load because you need to go to the bathroom.
Can I even tell the people that I'm so overloaded that unless somebody unloads me, I'll blow my bottom?
No, don't. Please don't. Wait until I need to vomit.
So what did I have to carry all this stuff for if I can't pull any of the jokes that Frinicus pulls or what Life is pulls or what a MCS pulls?
Well, just don't do it. Anytime I'm in the audience and have to watch any of these conscious efforts, I'm a year older when I leave the place.
Okay. Oh, poor me! Oh, my poor neck! I think it's broken now! It won't say anything funny.
Isn't this a sassy slave? I've spoiled him. Here am I, Dionysus, son of grape juice, wearing out my own feet. And I let him ride so he won't get tired carrying the bundle.
What do you mean I'm carrying them?
How can you? You're riding.
But I'm carrying.
How?
With an effort.
Isn't the donkey carrying what you're carrying?
Not carrying what I'm carrying, no, my golly.
Oh, then how can you carry what you're being carried?
Well, I don't know. I only know my shoulder is falling apart.
Okay, so the donkey isn't working.
No.
Why don't you pick him up and carry him?
Why wasn't I in that sea battle where they freed the slaves who fought? Then I could tell him to go jump in the lake.
Yeah.
Get down, you bum.
Yeah.
Here we are at the door. This is the place I've been looking for. First stop. Get down.
Ow!
Hey there. Inside! Hey, anybody home? Bang, bang!
Who's pounding on my door? Sounds like a set point coming from somewhere. What goes on?
Hey, boy!
What?
No, what? How scared he was!
Oh, yeah, scared! Scared from those bats.
My left to hold it in.
Come here, brother dear. I have a favor to ask.
I'll wait till I get rid of the giggles. Only I can't stop them. That lion skin being worn over that buttercup nighty. What's the idea? This meeting of the war club and the slipper. Where were you bound and did those panties bind?
Hell! I recently served aboard a kind of dreamboat called the RuPaul.
Oh, and did you engage?
We did. We sank a dozen. A baker's dozen of the enemy craft.
What? You two?
So help me, Apollo.
Then I woke up.
So then I'm sitting on deck, see, reading this new book, Andromeda by Euripides. All of a sudden it hits me over the heart. A craving. Can't think how hard.
A craving, little brother? What kind of craving? A big one?
A small one. Mullet size.
A craving for a woman?
No.
For a boy?
No.
For a man? Well, what about you, RuPaul, little brother?
Oh, please don't laugh at me, brother dear. Truly, I'm in a bad way. I've got this craving. It's demoralizing.
What kind of craving, little brother?
I don't know how to explain it. I'll paraphrase it by a parable. Did you ever feel a sudden longing for baked beans?
Baked beans? Oh, gosh, yes. That's happened to me a million times.
Well, shall I give you another illustration? Expound that one?
Don't need to expound baked beans to me.
Well, that's the kind of craving that's been eating. I'm craving for Euripides.
Euripides? What? Dead and all?
And no one's gonna persuade me to give up my plan of going after him.
When the Hades down below?
Absolutely! But lower than there! If there's anything there.
What do you want?
What I want is a clever poet. For some of them are gone. The ones who are left are bad.
What is an iPhone living?
Oh, he is the one good thing that is left. That is, if he really is any good. I'm not altogether sure about that.
Little brother, if you have to resurrect somebody, why not bring up Sophocles instead of Euripides?
Oh, no. I want to get Iophon all by himself, without Sophocles. Take him apart, see how he does. Besides, Euripides is a slippery character who'd like to make a jailbreak and come back with me. Sophocles behaved himself up here. He would down there.
What happened to
Agathon? Oh, he's gone. Left me. Oh, and he was a good poet, too. His friends miss him.
Where did he go?
To join the Saints for dinner.
Well, what about Xenocles?
Oh, I only wish he would die.
Angelus?
And nobody ever thinks of me. And look at me standing here with my shoulder practically falling off.
Oh, look, there's still a million and one young guys around. You know, tragic young poets who cannot gabble Euripides by country mile.
Oh, morning glory, just talking to themselves. Just Twitter birds and free verse writers. Sloppy craftsmen. What drama, and you never hear from them again. They sprinkle drama in passing like a dog at the pump. You tell me where you can find one honest-to-God poet to bark you out one good, round, solid, tragic verse.
Honest-to-God like what?
Honest-to-God like this. Someone with an adventurous style, as you should say. Right. Upper air. Zeus's penthouse. Or the foot of time. Or heart that would not swear upon the holy thing. Or tongue that once forswore, though the heart knew it not.
Oh, you really like that stuff?
It's absolutely dreamy, man.
It's awful. It's bilge. Nobody knows that better than you.
Rule not my mind. Thine own is thy mind. Rule thou it.
No, really, little brother, it does seem the most awful slob to me.
Well, you should stick to food.
And nobody ever thinks of me.
So let me tell you why I'm here, wearing this stuff that makes me look like you. So you can tell me about your friends who put you up when you went down there to fetch the caravan dog. Well, I could use some friends. So tell me about them. Tell me about the ports, the bakeries, the whorehouses, the parks and roadside rests, the springs and highways, the city, the boarding houses, and the best hotel's scarcest in bed money.
And nobody ever thinks of me!
You poor idiot. You're really going to try and get there.
Oh, no more of that stuff, please. Just tell me about the roads and what's the quickest way to Hades Underhouse. And don't make it a hot one. Not too cold, either.
What's my first recommendation? Let's see. Oh, what indeed. Here's a way. You need a footstool and a rope. Go hang yourself.
Stop! That's a stifling sort of way!
Well, there's a short, well-beaten path. Well-beaten? Be a mortar and pestle?
That's hemlock you're talking about?
Hemlock, nothing else but.
A chilly sort of way. Makes me shiver. Skins go numb.
Oh, shall I tell you about the quick downhill path?
Well, yes, I'd like that. I'm somebody who hates to walk.
Well, take just a short walk over to the Potter's Quarter.
Yes?
Climb the tower. The high tower.
What do I do then?
Oh, wait till they drop the torch. Signals the start of the race, and when they do, all the spectators around will yell, go! When they yell go, you go too.
Go where?
Over the edge! Over the edge! The tower.
Smash my twin buckets of brains! No, I won't go that way of yours.
What do you want?
The way you went. The deathless way.
But little brother, that's a long journey. First, you'll come to a great swampy lake. It's bottomless.
Well, then how do I get across?
Oh, there's an ancient mariner with a little tiny boat. He'll take you across, and you'll give him 2 bits for it.
Oh, gee, those 2 bits. You can't ever seem to be rid of them. How did they ever get here?
Oh, Theseus brought them over from Athens. After that, you'll see snakes. Armies of wild animals. Monsters.
Stop trying to scare me like this! You'll never stop me!
Next comes a great sea of mud and shit and springs eternal, with people stuck therein. Anyone who did injury to a guest or to a host, debauched a child and picked his pockets in the process, beat his mother, broke his father's jaw.
Took up jogging?
Broke his father's jaw, swore an oath and broke it, or copied the tragic speeches of Morsimos.
Don't stop there! I've got one more to add. Whoever learned the war dance by Canisius?
Next, you'll hear the lovely sound of flutes fall upon you, and you'll see a lovely light like this hot damn sun above here. Myrtles, solemn troops, endless societies of men and women, and an endless clapping of hands.
And who are they?
Oh, they're the blessed, the initiates.
And I'm the donkey carrying mystic properties. Well, I don't mean to keep them till the end of time.
Ask them. They'll tell you everything else you need to know, for they live closest to the road you must go. Their habitation is by Pluto's door. So good luck, little brother. He's going to need it.
Oh, same to you. Keep healthy. Boy, pick up those bundles.
You mean before I put them down?
Get a move on.
Oh, please. Please, please don't make me do it. Why don't you hire one of those sticks they're carrying out, huh? There's bound to be one soon.
What if I can't get one?
Well, then I'll do it.
Very well. Oh, look, here comes the corpse now being carried out.
Got a boat to catch. Gonna get me there before I start to decompose?
Hey!
Whoa, that highway sign. We're in New Jersey. You sure you know how to go to hell?
Hey there!
You union guys, you necrophiliacs or something, I feel like I'm getting screwed.
Dare you there! That dead one, I'm talking to you.
Yeah.
Want to carry some packages to Haiti?
How much?
That much.
Oh God!
Yeah!
okay, $2. Give me $2.
My God, no, that's too much.
Keep carrying me, guys.
No, wait a minute. We've got to be able to work this out. What's the matter?
$2. Put a perch on up.
Make it 1.5.
I'd sooner come to life again.
Stuck up bastard, isn't he? To hell with him!
Where are we going again?
Okay, come on, guys. Look. Left, $2. Right, left, hell. You got it?
Yeah.
Don't worry, Master. I'll carry the bundles.
You are nature's nobleman.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, let's go catch a boat.
Whoa! Coming alongside!
What indeed? Oh, here's the lake right where he said it would be. And now here comes the boat.
So help me, Poseidon, so it is. And Charon, too.
Oh, carry me, Charon. Oh, sweet chariot, carry me home!
Who wants a crew? Relaxation from business worries, meadows of forgetting, or horse featherland? Going to the dogs? Going to the birds? Going to hell?
Me!
Oh, then get aboard! Take a leg!
What do you think we're bound for? Strictly for the birds?
With you on board? Get on! Get on!
I hear, boy.
No! I will not take a slave! Only a veteran of our high-saving sea battle!
Well, I would have been there, but I was sick. I had the pink eye.
Well, then, you can take a little walk around the lake.
Well, where shall I find you?
At the Dome of the Parching Thirst! At the Pullock!
You got that?
Oh yeah, I got it! I wish I was dead! What kind of bad luck sign did I run into this morning?
You! Stick to your oar! Anyone else coming? Hurry up! Want to go to hell? You there! What do you think you're doing?
Setting to my oar! Exactly what I was told to do!
Well, fatso! Sit here! Sit like this! Oh, up here. Oh, you got it?
Okay.
Got it. Now, I want you to put your arms away and bring them back. Oh! 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 Stop being an ass, will you? And bring your arms up and put some weight into it. Get up here. Come on, there's no time in hell. Let's go.
What do you want from me? I've never rowed before. I'm no old Navy man. I never made the first crew. How am I supposed to row?
Easily. Just begin to do it, and you'll get a lovely swan song to give you the time.
Well, who's singing?
Oh, it's a lovely swan song, but the swans are lovely frogs.
Very well, then. Give me the stroke. No! Oh, no! Get me started. No! Give me the timing.
Get on. Oompa, 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 oompa.
Fresh water, ponds, and springs. Gather we all together now and swell our lofty well-poken chorus. Poets, poets, how high is this righteous song we sing to the son of Zeus?
Beginning to fail. I'm raising blisters on my tail. Coax, coax, I think I am. And possibly you don't care a damn.
Coax, coax.
All I can hear is coax. Go away, I'd like to give you that.
By singing, when with the music of touchy my lyrical song is heard in the bubbly water.
We wiggle and dive in the horse flowers, light on the lily pads, and die and duck as we sing.
And when Zeus makes it rain and green escape to the poppy waters, our song still pulses and bubbles up from below.
Rip-a-pa-pa-peeps, collapse, collapse. I'm picking up the rhythm from you, Chip.
I'm sorry for us if you join in.
I'm sorry for me if I begin to split in two, from bottom to chin. And to hell with you, I don't care what you do.
Whatever you say, we'll croak all good. As long as we're stout!
Take a guess! Collax! Collax! There! I can do it better than you!
No! We can do it better than you!
I can do it better than you, and I'll croak away if it takes all day! Rick-a-kick-a-kick, coax, coax! And I'll poke you all down in the grand climax! Rick-a-kick-a-kick, coax, coax! There! I know I can do it better than you! You and your coax!
Oh, easy, easy!
Doors up!
Everybody up! Time for you to pay your fare!
You're a two-bit, my dear friend. Champions! Hey! Champions! Now, where's he got to? Champions!
Hello!
What's over there?
Lots of mud and darkness.
Oh, well, did you see those criminal types he was talking about? You know, the murderers and swindlers.
Well, haven't you seen them?
Oh, yeah! Now I know where to look.
5, 10.
Ah, yes, they're all there. All right, what do we do next?
I think we should get out of here. This is that place where he said those wild animals would be, you know, those monsters.
Oh, him. He was just talking big, trying to scare me.
Huh?
I tell you, he knows what a fighting man I am, and it just makes him jealous. I tell you, there's no one more vain than Karen. Still, I wish we had met some terrifying thing. Monstrous struggle to make the trip worthwhile.
You know, I think I do hear something moving about.
Well, which direction?
Right behind us.
Behind?
Oh, no, no, no. Now it's in front.
Oh, when you stay in front.
Oh, I see it. It's an enormous thing. A wild animal.
What does it look like?
Well, it keeps changing shape. Now it's a cow. Now it's a donkey. Ooh, now it's a girl.
Woo-hoo.
What a beauty.
Oh, well, let me at her. Where'd she go?
Too late. No girl any longer. She turned into a bitch.
Huh. It's Imposa!
Well, wherever she is, she done caught fire. Her face is burning.
Oh, does she have one brazen leg?
She does, and the other one's made of dung. I'm not lying!
Oh, where can I run to?
Where can I?
Oh, oh, save me, your reverence. We belong to the same lodge.
Lord God, Hercules, we're alone!
Oh, don't, Bill. Don't call me that. Don't give away my name, please.
Lord Dionysus!
Oh, no! Go on the way you were. That was even worse.
Look! Master, over here!
You got something?
Oh, it's no need to be frightened. We've come out all right. And now I can speak the line Hegelikos spoke. The storm is over, and the clam has stilled the waves, and Usa's gone.
Do you swear it?
So help me Zeus.
Swear it!
So help me Zeus.
Swear it!
Ah, help me Zeus!
Oh, what a fright. When I saw her, I lost all my pretty color.
Yes, our donkey had a fright too, so you're all in yellow.
What did I ever do to deserve this? Which of you gods should I hold responsible for this?
Bright upper airs, Zeus's penthouse, or the foot of dog!
Hey, you!
What?
What is it? Hear that?
Hear what?
The sound of flutes being blown.
I hear it too, and there's a crackle and smell of torches. Seems like mystery is going on.
I think you're right. Maybe we better squat over here quiet-like and listen in.
Iacos! 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 Oh, Iacos!
See, Master, it's just as I told you, just as I thought. It's the initiates, remember? He told us their playground is hereabouts. They sing the Iacos song by that noted theologian, Diagoras.
I think you're right. But still, we better sit here quiet until we figure out exactly what goes on.
Iacos! All beloved in these pastures, all in plenty! Iacos! Oh, Iacos!
Come to me, come with dance steps down the meadow to your worship.
life bursting, the immortal linen wreath garland on your brow.
And gold-footed, stamp-out the sprightly measure of the dance is full of graces!
All light and sweet and sacred for your dedicated chosen one!
Fragrance wafts upon me, roasting pigs!
If I promise you a handful of tripe, will you sit down?
Let flames fly as the torch tosses in man's hold! Iacos! Oh, Iacos!
Star of fire in the high rites of the nighttime!
The field shines in the torchlight!
And the old man's knees are limber.
They shake off aches and miseries.
And the years of their antiquity drop from them in a magical measure.
Oh, torch in hand shining, Iacos, go before us to the lush flowers and the meadows and the blessed revels of dances.
Banned from our choruses any whose brain cannot fathom the gist of our wit.
Whose hearts and feelings are dirty.
Who never has witnessed or never partaken of genuine culture.
Who knows not the speech of bull gobble fratinos.
Who knows not the Bacchic fraternity.
Who laughs at cheap jokes that should not have been made.
Who writes such stuff at the wrong time.
Who stirs up sedition, dissension, and hate.
Who does not like the Athenians?
Who loves to make money out of our quarrels and likes them and bangs them to fury?
Who holds high office and then takes bribes when the city is tossed in the temple?
Who sells out a ship or a fort to the enemy, smuggling our secret intelligence from Aena over to Epiduros?
Like any goddamn tax-collecting curriculum with his four paths and sails he pitched that were meant for our navy.
Who goes on his rounds to collect contributions to finance the enemy's war fleet.
Who humming and cyclical verses the while makes the Hickory Shrine a back house.
Who gets up to speak in the public assembly and nibbles at the fees of the poets just because they once made a fool of him in the plays that our fathers established.
Such men, I forbid.
Yes.
And again, I forbid them.
Yes.
And again, I forbid them a third time.
Yes.
Let them get up and go from our coral misery.
All others! Strike it! Hey! Come on! Strike up the singing and dance of our holy and night-long revels befitting this solemn occasion. And there's
all now! Into the flower-strewn hollows of meadow fields, scattered slowly, and jeer, and sneer, and mock, and be outrageous. All are well stuffed full with food. Advance, advance, sing strongly, Our Lady of Salvation,
and march and match
your singing. She promises to stay on our land. For all the Rivian can do.
Come now and all to the tune of the song, for the queen of the bountiful seasons. Sing loud, sing long, and dance to the song for Demeter, our mistress and goddess.
Demeter, mistress of brave and gay, stand by now and help me win. Protect this chorus, it is your own. Me in safety all this day. Play on and do my dances.
Help me say what will make them grin.
Help me say what will make them think.
Help me say what will make me win on this your festival today and wear the victor's garland. Change the tune.
What?
Sing now to the pretty god of the day. Summon him to join us. We have a sacred way to go, and he goes with us.
Iacos, well beloved spirit of song, oh, be my leader and march along with me this holy way.
Bring me to Lucius, swift and musically, to you I pray.
Iacos,
Love of this! Help me on my way!
You split my shirt to make them laugh and boo!
You split my cheap little shoes and
my brand smoke on me!
You know how to make do!
Wartime economy!
Iacos, lover of dancing, help me on my way!
I saw a sweet little girl up in the crowd today. Ooh, and as she bent over, her dress, I swear, busted open. And I was happy to stare at a bosomy eyeball. Oh, Iacos! Lover of dancing, help me on my way!
I'm a fellow who's always been good at following my leader. I gladly come up there and help you play with her.
And still he hasn't paid it! Now he's among the upworld citizens!
Nobody up there can claim a similar fame for being a bastard! And from Paul, they tell me, sits mourning among the tombstones and tears the hair from his you know where and batters his jawbone!
He was bound in his usual posture. Tears, for no friend of his after in Sabinos, the man of police.
And Callius, they say, the son of Pony Play, wears a panoply and goes to sea in ship.
Can any of you tell me where Pluto happens to dwell? We're a visiting fireman. Never been here before.
Just stop bothering us so. You haven't far to go.
He lives right here. Walk up and knock at the door.
Sure. Boy, pick up the bundle. Oh,
yeah. What is the matter with this guy? Pick up. It's nothing but pick up the bundle.
Lay up.
Our pet
100-headed viper waits to gnaw at your gizzard, while Urena, eel of hell, shall have your lungs to chew at.
Oh, I need my lungs, please.
And then, your innards and your kidneys and your bleeding bowels will all go to the Teth Raceman and Dorga. Oh, they'll chew you up! I think I hear them straining at the leash. I'm gonna go let them loose on you. Later, Chuck.
What's the matter, boss?
I can't hold it anymore. Is there a god in the house?
You clown! Don't disgrace us! Alley-oop on your feet before somebody sees us.
But I feel so faint. Be a good chap. Put a wet sponge over my heart.
Here. You put it.
Where are we?
Well, you know, I'm really not sure. I think we took the wrong place. Oh, you golden gods, is that where you keep your heart?
Well, you see, the poor little thing, she got so frightened, she crept out there to hide.
You are the worst coward of all gods in men!
Who, me? Call me coward? I asked for a sponge, didn't I? No one else would have done that.
What would they have done?
Laid there and stunk. That's what a good coward would have done. And besides, I'm on my feet again, and united I stand.
That's manliness, by Poseidon.
Goodness gracious, yes. She said such awful things and talked so loud. Weren't you just a little bit frightened?
Hell no. I never gave it a second thought.
Well, I tell you what, then. I guess you win. You're the hero, boy. So, you be me. Here's the club. Here's the lion skin. I'll be you. You're the guy with the fearless guts. I'll take my turn with the double bag.
No, I cannot but obey thee. Quick, quick, hurry up. Get in here.
Everybody look at me! I'm...
Pantheocles.
Now see if I'm a sissy boy like you. Ha!
You look like someone who came from the same ward, but got run out on a rail. Oh, guess it's my turn to take the duffel bag.
Why, Heracles, darling, it's you! When the mistress heard you might be around, she put the buns in the oven and lit the stove and put a pot of beans to cook. And, oh yes, barbecued you a steer.
No one offered me a whole steer.
And there'll be cakes and cookies, so come on in.
It's a club that's always practiced different valley.
Please,
roasting
the salted nuts.
Nuts to him, I say.
Mixing the wines and vintage stuff. So here.
Yep. Well, I'm...
Go inside.
Oh, I'm afraid I really can't. So sweet.
Don't be so silly. I won't let you get away. Let's see. There's a flute player girl waiting for you inside, and she's lovely, and two or three dancers too, I believe. And
what can you say? Dancing girls.
Pretty.
Serious, did you? When I got you up as Heracles for fun? Xanthius, will you kindly stop being such an ass? Here's the baggage.
What?
Take it. It's all yours.
What are you saying? Are you thinking of taking back what you gave me?
I'm not thinking about it. I'm doing it.
No, help! Help, witness! Oh, make a note! Oh, oh, this in the hands of my gods.
What gods, you idiot?
All right.
Thinking you could be Heracles, Alcmene's son, when you're human, and a slave at that.
Oh, the hell with it. Here, take it, take it. But perhaps, God willing, someday you'll find you need me after all.
Now that's an adaptable guy. Must have been in the Navy.
He's been around. He'll never get drowned. Always knows where the gravy is.
The ship's on her beam, and he's on the side that's dry.
He's got super sensory vision, like our local politician, Theramenes.
Just call him Galosh or any old boot you can easily put on your right or your left hand foot.
Hey.
Now, here's what would have been funny. Picture it like this. Here's Xanthius and his honey, ready to kiss. But he's got to go. So I hold the pot for him, and I make a pass at the girls. Anyway, he's on to it. So he hauls back and sucks me one in the teeth. And knocks the spots right out of Attic Tragedy. Quickly.
now, Rupert?
Sorry.
Come on. Now you've got a reputation to live up to.
I remember the kind of god you're supposed to be.
Well, act accordingly.
Hey! Oh! Be rough and tough, or you'll be reduced to the bottom roof and have to carry the stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen!
That's a good point. It's not so far off the mark, but you know, I thought of that too. If it's anything bad, this lovely lad hands it to me.
Right.
Anything good, he'd take it back if he could.
Every time.
I'll chew brave herbs.
Yeah.
And I won't take fright, so fight for Xanthias.
Yeah!
And it's time for it, boys. I hear a noise. The door's trouble coming this way.
Trouble. There's the dog stealer.
Get him, boys!
Yeah.
Tie him up and take him away, we'll fix him!
Somebody's gonna be sorry!
The hell with you! Get away from me! Oh!
What will you do? Hey, Diddlis, hit part all goes! Take it out of your boys, there's a fight going on!
Fight! Shocking, isn't it? The way he steals from you, and then assaults!
Whoa!
What? He's too big for
me. Outrageous! Should not be allowed!
Yeah. So help me, Zeus, and hope to die if I ever was in this place before, or ever stole a hair's worth of goods that belong to you. Here, I'll make you a gentlemanly proposition, my lady.
Yeah.
Here's my slave boy. Take him, put him to the torture, then kill me if you find I did anything wrong.
What torture?
Oh, try them all! Tie him up! Hang him upside down!
Yeah, hit him with a whip of bristles! Take his skin off!
Twist him on the rack! Pour vinegar up his nose! Pile tricks on him! Just give him the worst! Only please excuse him from anything gentle, like soft onion whips or leeks!
Why, fair enough. And if I hit your sleigh too hard and I cripple him, the damage is
baby. Never mind, baby! Take him away to work on him!
Oh, that's double.
I'll do it right here. He'll confess in front of your eyes. All right, drop that baggage, be quick about it.
All right.
See that you don't tell me any lies.
Oh! 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 I protest! I'm warning everyone not to torture me! I'm a god!
What are you talking about?
I am immortal! Dionysus, son of Zeus, and he's the slave.
Slowly I turn, step by step.
Sure, I hear him, sure.
All the better reason for him to get a good whipping.
Yeah.
You know, if he's really a god, he won't feel anything.
Yeah.
Well, you're claiming to be a god too, so how about it?
Yeah.
Shouldn't you get as many strokes as I do?
That's fair enough too, whip us both. And if you see either of us paying any attention or crying out of pain at what you're doing, then you'll know one of us isn't a god.
Yeah, all right.
He must be a gentleman, can't be a doubt about it the way that the trial seems.
Yeah.
All right, strip both.
Hello, Bryce!
How are you going to make this even?
Easy! Get back! I'm going to hit one of you first. And then the other one, and so on and so forth.
Come on, right. Time's up! Let's go! Hit him!
And when you hit me, see if I move.
Get him a good one!
Did you hit me, see if I move? Did I move?
What?
What? I did hit you.
The hell you did!
I must have missed another
trick. Hit him!
Come on, are you going to hit me?
I did hit you already.
Why didn't I sneeze? I do so when I'm tickled.
Don't
know.
Let her try this.
Are you supposed to be doing something? Oh my gosh!
My gosh?
That hurt, did it?
Yeah, just thought of something. Time for my feast to Diomia, and the enemy won't let me hold it.
Smash, too religious. I can't get to him. I haven't read this bag yet.
Yeah, come on. Give it to him. Yeah.
What's the matter?
Oh, there go the cavalry. That's their cry.
There's tears in your eyes.
I got a whiff of their onion rash.
Oh. It didn't feel anything.
Nothing that would bother me.
I better go try this.
Yeah.
What's the matter?
Pull this thing out, will you, Thor?
Where am I getting to?
Oh, Lord Delos and Python!
That hurt him, didn't you hear?
It did not! I was merely quoting a verse of Hippodax.
Of course. Hippodax.
You aren't trying! Give him a good hard whack in the ribs.
Yeah! Come on!
Turn him around!
Give him a good
hard. Somebody did get hurt that time!
I feel good!
The
mistress, you're quite right. Although I wish you'd thought of that before, so you wouldn't have had to whack me.
No, but it was
fine.
Oh, well.
Ah! Ah! Oh, God! Oh, God! The holy horses, come to us, come! And all enjoy my music! Cast your eyes on this multitude of wits here seated! Sharper than Cleopon, that sharper, on whose nose spick a pinion be, mutters bad kitchen attic. Thracian swallowbird he, perched on a barberry black ball bushy, singing his mournful nightingale trinity, how he must hang, though the oaths come out equal.
It's the right and duty of our sacred course to determine better courses for our city. Here's the first text of our sermon.
All the citizens should be equal.
Good.
And have their fears taken away.
Yeah.
All who were tricked by Trinicus, caught and held and led astray, ought to be allowed to join the rest of us who slipped away.
Amnesty! Yeah. Let's all forgive them for mistakes made long ago. Nobody in our community ought to lose his civic right.
Isn't it unfair that having been in one sea fight, slaves should have plutonian status and be over men once for all.
Please, I'm not against their freedom in itself.
I quite agree.
They deserve it. That's the only thing you've done intelligently.
Right. Still, there are those other men who also often fought at sea by your side, whose fathers also fought for us. Akin by blood to you.
Let their one fault be forgotten.
Let them know your mercy too.
Oh, Athenians, wise beyond all of them, and forget your rage.
Thank you.
Any man who fights at sea beside us, let him be our friend.
Thank you.
Take him as a citizen, honored kinsman. Let all hatred end.
Now the city is caught in the storm and struggles in the grip of the waves. Surely. This is not the time for your old, hard, exclusive pride.
Someday you will regret it if you leave unsaid the word that's saying.
If I have true discrimination to judge a man in his sorrow, not long will our current baboon be here to bother us.
Yeah. That is little Clygenes, chiefest of all the lords of the Babel whirlpool bath where soaps without soda.
What they really use is the clay of Kimmelwolf.
Now he won't be around very long, and he knows it. But he carries a club against robbers whenever he goes under one of his drunken throws.
We've been thinking much of late about the way the city treats all the choicest souls among its citizens. It seems to be like the recent coinage as compared with the old currency.
We still have the ancient money. Finest coins, I think, in Greece. Finer than the coins of Asia. Clink them, and they ring the bell. Truly fashioned, nothing phony, round and honest, every piece.
Do we ever use it?
We do not. Instead, we use this wretched brass, last week's vintage. Cheap, light, phony, looks like hell.
Well, now let's compare the citizens. We have some stately gentlemen. Modest, anciently descended, proud and educated well on the wrestling ground. Men of distinction.
We outrage and reject, preferring instead any foreign fool or redhead slave or brazen clown or shyster.
And this is what we choose to direct our city immigrants!
Once we would not use one of these as a public scapegoat.
That was in the former days.
Now we love them.
Hey, you idiots! Turn about and change your ways!
Use our useful man.
That will look best in case of victory.
Hang we must, if we must hang. But let's at least hang from a handsome tree.
Yes.
Cultured gentlemen should bear their sufferings with dignity.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, go home!
Master, you're as blessed as the Savior. He's a man of parts, gentlemen.
Ha! Yeah, that's a logical conclusion. If Trencherman plus Wencherman means gentleman.
Oh, he'd have down on the mat and beat you up when you said you were a slave and you went to the master.
He'd have been sorry if he had.
Good slavemanship, that. Well played, exactly the way I like to do it.
Come again, you like what?
Well, you know, seeing myself off in action, you know, when I get off where my master can't hear, I curse at him.
What about sneaking out of doors after a good beating and muttering at your master?
I like that too.
And poking into his business?
No, can you think of anything nicer?
My sister by Zeus? What about listening in keyholes when masters are gossiping?
Just about sent me crazy!
And spreading secrets you listen in on like that?
Who, me? That's not just crazy, man, that is super crazy plus.
Phoebus Apollo, you're one of us! Give us the grip.
Oh!
And then please tell me in the name of Zeus of the Slaves, who wears his stripes with us, what's all the yelling and racket and screaming? What goes on inside?
Well, one's Aeschylus and one's Euripides.
Uh-huh.
Oh, it's big business. Big business.
What's it all about?
Well, we have to set this custom here for an award for literature in the humanities. And the one who's best at the work he does is to, you know, eat dinner in the Capitol and sit in the chair next to Pluto.
I see.
Hey! Until somebody comes along better than he is, and then he has to
Well, I don't see Aeschylus having anything to worry about.
Oh, yeah. He held the chair for tragedy, and he's the best at writing.
Well, so who is now?
Then Euripides came down here and he slaved for all the rogues and the safe crackers and the sneak thieves and the pickpockets and the juvenile delinquents and there's a lot of that down here in Hades.
Yeah.
All his disputations and his wrigglings and his twists and they go crazy men who thinking he was the cleverest writer. And that all went through his head, and so he challenged for the chair where Aeschylus was sitting.
Well, didn't they throw him out?
No, they did not. They yelled out for a contest to see which one was better than the other.
Oh, you mean the criminal public yell?
Sure, and they cried out to him.
Well, now, how come Sophocles didn't make a bid for the tragic chair, huh?
Oh, he never even tried to. He got down here, walked up to Aeschylus, shook his hand, kissed him, and gave up his right on the chair in favor of him. His idea, couldn't he even tell me, was to sit on the bench as a substitute. If Aeschylus wins, he'll stay where he's at. If he loses, he needs to fight for his own art against Euripides.
So the whole thing's coming off.
Zeus, yeah, it's just a little wild. And then they're gonna have all the terrors of tragedy will be let loose. Oh, God. They're gonna get out the scale to weigh the music up.
Yeah, well, what's the idea of that? Short-changing tragedy?
Yeah, they're gonna get these thrillers, cheese squares, and then find the fold.
Yeah, bricklayers reunion.
Badges and calipers. Euripides says you have to bring the cheese of tragedy.
Oh, I bet all this is making Aeschylus pretty mad.
Oh, God, he got down like a bull ready to charge.
Woohoo! Say, who's going to judge us?
So that was pretty hard. You know, they tell me intellectuals pretty hard to find it. Aeschylus didn't go down so good with the Athenians.
Maybe they realized most of them were bank robbers.
Anyway, they thought it was pretty ridiculous for him. They just had poets and judge poets. And the master came along and they handed it to him. You know what I'm saying? We better go. You know what happens when the master is tired.
Screams and yells of pain from us.
They're both the deepest sea now, a thunderbolt whipping inside.
When the rapture sharpening he sees of his multi-lacious antagonist to encounter him. Then shall ensue dread time of fury.
Horse and crested phrases shall shock in helm-tossing combat. Chariots collide in realm of wreckage and splinter-flown action. Warriors beating off, brain-crafted warriors, cavalry speeches.
Bristling the hairy mane of his neck of self-grown horsehair. Mellowing, he shall blast the bolts from compacted joinery. Banging plank by plank, nailed sections of verse and starburst gigantic. Slim-shaped tongue unraveling to champ on the bit of malignant. Wickedly shall chip and chomp at its tropes. Much labor of love worth. Yeah. All rise! Oh. Here come the judge!
Here come the judge! Everybody ready to toast! Here come the judge! Here come the judge! Here come the judge! Everybody ready to toast! Here come the judge!
You may be seated!
I will not give up the chair, so stop trying to tell me to! I tell you, I'm a better poet than he is!
Well, Aeschylus, you heard him. Don't you have anything to say?
He's always started with a line of scornful silences. He used to use them in his plays to mystify us.
Don't be overconfident!
I know this man. I've studied him for a long time. His verse is fiercely made, all full of sound and fury. Language, unbridled, uncontrolled, ungated in, untalkable around, bundles of blasted boast.
You child of the cabbage patch goddess. You jabber compiler. Why, you rag stitcher together. You say this to me? Say it again, and you'll be sorry.
No, Aeschylus,
don't give your passion, blow your mortal coils in oil.
I'll not stop until I've shown in detail what kind of one-legged poet that is who talks so big.
Oh, Black Rains! Black Rams,
Black
boys! Fet wind and fetch us Black Rams! Sacrifice to the hurricane! It's on the way!
Compiler of Cretan soul, Arius! You debase our art by staging impudent and impure marriages.
Now, most honorable Aeschylus, please, stop right there. And you, my poor Euripides. If you have any sense, you'll take yourself out of the path of the storm. Before its hail breaks open your head, and your telephone oozes out in the light of your face. Now, gently, criticize, don't yell! It is not becoming for two poets and gentlemen to argue like two bakers' wives. You're crackling like an oak log that's been set ablaze.
I'm ready for him. Don't even try to get me to back down. I'll bite before I'm bitten, and that's what he wants. With lines, with music, the gut strings of tragedy. And with my finest plays. With Peleus. With Meleagros.
us. And best of all, with telephones.
What you want to do.
I'd rather we would not have staged the match down here. It's not fair. We don't start even.
What do you mean?
I mean that my work did not die with me, but his did, so he's But it's your decision. You have to do it.
Then, bring on the fire and the incense.
Burn incense!
While I, in the presence of these great intelligences, pray that I may judge this match most literally. You, chorus, meanwhile, sing you an anthem to the music. I'm sure they'll get better.
Nostrils, oh, grant that I be critical in all my arguments!
We're all eager to listen to the two great wits debating and stating the luminous course of their Wissenschaft.
Wit shall wrestle wit, fall upon fall. Tough speech, nothing mild. Tough talk.
Neither is dull.
From one, we'll get witty design, polish, and fire.
The other can pull up trees by the roots for his use. Those words cut smooth on steel, heat of lines.
One is a wrestler, bomb, ha!
Quick, the other one, deft and defensive throws.
Get on with it, yes. Get on with it. And put your finest wit in all you say. And be concrete. And be exact. And be original.
A later ceremony after having demonstrated that my rival is a phony. His audience was a lot of louts, and Criticus was all they knew. He tipped and cheated them with ease. And here's one more thing he used to do. He'd start with one veiled, bundled, muffled character plunked right in place, Achilles-like or Niobe, but nobody could see its face. That looked like drama, sure, but not one syllable would it mutter.
By Jove, they did it, and that's a fact.
The choruses then would utter four huge concatenations of verse. The characters just sat there numb.
You know, I like them quiet like that. I'd rather have them silent than yak, yak, yak.
Yak, 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 yak,
by all means, and to be sure. But what was Aeschylus trying to do?
Phony effects! The audience sat there and watched the panorama breathlessly. When will Niobe speak? And that was half the drama.
Oh, the old shell game. I've been had. Aeschylus, why this agitation? You're looking cross and at a loss.
He does not like investigation. And then, after all this, and the play is halfway through, the character is grunting, mooing, doesn't calcise lines or two, with beetling brows and hairy crests like voodoo goblins all cut up. Incomprehensible, of course.
You are killing me!
Would you be quiet? Hit
it. Hit it.
Well,
indeed.
Anyway.
He did not say one single word you could understand.
Yes, Aeschylus, go grind your teeth.
But battles of scamandros, barbicans with ditches underneath, hook-nosed eagles bronzen wrought onto shields, versus arms like infantry, not altogether easy to make out the sense.
You're telling me. Many a night I've laid awake and puzzled on just one single word. A humid rooster horse is pleased exactly just what kind of bird?
It's a simple painted on the galley, you ignorant block.
I thought it was a Rixies or Felicito's mighty cock.
Well, should a rooster Bulgabud get into tragedy at all?
Well, tell me, what are your creations, you freethinker, if you have the gall?
No rooster horses! Bull moose goats, nor many of the millions of monsters the Medes and Persians paint on their pavilions. When I took over our craft from you, I immediately became aware that she was gassy from having been stuffed with heavy text and noisy air. So I eased her aches and reduced the swelling and removed the weights and heats with neat conceits and cheating cheeks, with parsnips, radishes, and beets. I fed her on smashed and pre-digested baby food, strained from my own books, and fed her on solo audio.
The Beast-a-Bot had you in his hooks.
My openings were never complicated or drawn out. They were not difficult. From the beginning, my first character would give the background of the plot at once!
Better than giving away your personal background, eh?
And from the opening, no person was ever left with nothing to do. Each person stepped forward to speak his piece. The mistress spoke. The slave spoke. The master spoke. The daughter spoke. And grandma spoke.
And tell me why you were not hanged for daring that.
No, cross my heart and hope to die. I made drama democratic.
Weren't a particular shiny light in that line of thought.
I taught natural conversational dialogue.
Sure, and that, long before you taught them that, I wish you'd split in the middle.
Those delicate tests and verbalized commensuration and squint and fraud and get and God and loving application and always to think the worst of everything!
So I believe.
I staged the life of every day, the way we live it. I couldn't deceive my audience with the sort of stuff they knew about as much as I did. They just spotted me right away. So I played it straight and did not try to bind a verbal spell and hypnotize and lead them by the noses with memons and cagnosis, with rings on their fingers and bells on their toes. Just each of us, by our influence on our followers, give him manis, formicios, neganatos, sundry creeps and zanies, big mustachioed bugle boys, and high tree benders 12 foot high. But Clydophone is mine, and so is Theramenes, a clever guy.
I'll grant you Theramenes. Falls in a puddle and comes out dry. The man is quick and very slick. A true Euripidean. When Chians are in trouble, he's no Chian. He's a Chian.
That is what my plays are all about, and these are my contributions. And I turn everything inside out looking for new solutions to the problems of today. Always critical. Always giving suggestions for gracious living, and they come away from a play in a questioning mood with, where am I at? And who took my this? And who's got my that?
Who got my wallet?
Hey, yes.
Hey, yes.
Of yours, and watch you come stomping home and yell at the servants, everyone. Where, oh, where have my pitchers gone? Where is the maid who hath betrayed my fishes to the garbage trade? Where are the pots of yesteryear? Where is the garlic of yesterday? Who hath ravished my oil away? Formerly, they sent my pits fresh out of the sticks, with their jaws hung down in a witless way.
See you this,
glorious Achilles.
What have you to say?
Don't let your rage sweep you away,
or you'll never be victorious.
This cynical sage hits hard.
Mind the controls.
Don't lead with your chin.
Take skysails in.
Scud under bare poles.
Easy now. Keep him full in your sights.
When the wind falls, watch him.
Then and catch him.
Dead to rights.
Oh. Grand old adventure for me. Grand old bulwark of Balderdash! Front speech of Hellenic tragedy! Yeah. Open the faucets and let her splash!
Thing gives me a pain in the middle. My anger and resentment are heated at the idea of having to argue with him. So he won't think I'm defeated. Tell me this, you. What is the duty of a poet, and why are poets respected?
Because he can write, and because he can think, but mostly because he's injected some virtue into the body politic.
I suppose you break that trusted, corrupt, good, right-thinking man and fill him with treacherous lust. If a poet does that, what kind of a reward should he get?
Money!
The axe! That's what he gives him.
Look at the people I gave him, and look at those people when he got through with them. I left a real generation of heroic six-footers, a whole generation of heroes, not today's gangsters and decadent criminals. My heroes started with fear and splendor, with white plumes and stricken field. Old generation of heroes in shining arms with greaves and seven-foot oxide shields.
And that's a disease that will never die out. The munition makers will kill me.
What did you do to make them so noble? Is that what you're trying to tell me?
Yes, Aeschylus, don't withdraw to injure dignity. That don't go. Answer him.
I made them a martial drama.
Which?
Seven against thieves. Any man sitting there, sitting through that, would have been moved to heroic endeavor.
But that was a mistake, man. Why did you make the Thebans more warlike than ever and harder to fight with? By all means, that should be a good beating for you.
Good practice, austerity, but that's exactly what you wouldn't do. So then I put in my Persians, and anyone witnessing that was smitten with a desire for victory over the enemy. Best play I ever wrote.
I love that one. And I thrilled where I sat when I heard old Darius was dead. And the chorus cried, Wahoo! I tell you, it went to my head.
Oh, there's always work for poets who are also men. From earliest times, inspiration for virtue and practical wisdom has been made by the makers of rhyme. Why, Orpheus taught us to preach against murder and taught us heavenly wisdom. Eusebius, divination and medicine. And Hesiod, the day-by-day cultivation of the fields, the seasons and the plowing. And Homer, divinely inspired, was a source of indoctrination to virtue. Why else is he praised for showing us how the heroes armed themselves for battle?
Oh, but he didn't teach Pantocles. He can't get it right. I saw him the other night. He was called to parade, don't you know? And he put on his helmet and tried to tie up the plume while the helm was on top of his head.
Many were my heroic disciples, Lamachus being the last, who recently died. The man in the street had to catch something of my heroics and bravery. Why, my Teucers and my Patrocles lifted him out of his knavery and made him feel the thrill of battle and step to the tune of the trumpet. I never regaled him with Fedra the floozy or Zenobia the strumpet. I can say that lovesick women were never pictured by me.
Yeah, Aphrodite never did notice you that.
Aphrodite can climb a tree. You can't complain that she didn't bestow her attentions on you. She got to you in person.
She did! And your stories came true. The fictitious chickens came home to roost.
Old man without pity. Suppose I were to write about Spinovia. What harm has she done our city?
The Lariphron intrigues as set by you have caused respectable wives of respectable men out of shame and confusion to take their own lives.
But isn't my story of Phaedra a story that really has happened?
Yes. It's true. But the poet must cover up scandal. It should never let anyone see it. It should not be exhibited out there in the state. Not when our young boys are growing up to have their teachers as their models. But when they grow up, the poets must act as their preachers and preach to them what is useful and good.
Yeah, but you with your massive constructions, huge words, and mountainous phrases. Is that what you call useful instruction? You ought to make people talk like people.
Your folksy style is for the birds. For magnificent thoughts and magnificent insights, we need magnificent words. It's appropriate for the demagogues to talk bigger than we. That is why they're represented as grander in costume and figure. I set a standard of purity and you corrupted it!
Yeah. How did I do it?
By showing a royal man clad in rags with his skin showing through. You appeal to the emotions.
Hey, why should it be so wrong to awaken their pity?
The rich man will not contribute to the fleet. Oh, no, nobody in the city will give. You can see him going about in rags, howling and complaining that he's broke.
But he always has soft and expensive underwear on. The liar's so rich and he eats so much he has to give some to the fishes.
You taught the young man to be disputatious. Each argues as long as he wants to. You've emptied the wrestling yards of the wrestlers and now they sit in their fanny listening to adolescent debates. The sailor man gossips like granny and questions the orders of his superior. In my day, all they knew how to do was holler for rations, go yay ho, and go
together. And blast in the face of the man behind. That's something else they knew how to do. And how to steal from the magic sea, and how to be robbers ashore. But now, they argue their orders. We just can't send to sea anymore.
That's what he's begun. What hasn't he done? His nurses proposition others. Why, his heroines have their babies in the chapel and go and lie with their brothers and shout his life, life. While the street is rife with the clerk and the jerk, with the chapel baboon, and with the politician ape. Physical fitness is such a disgrace that no one is able to carry a torch in the race.
You're telling me. I laughed till I cried. Had it be a while ago, as the torch relay runners came by, there was this one guy. He was tough. He was slow. He was white. He was fat. He was left behind, and he didn't know where he was at. And the Pottery Works gang stood at the gate to give him a bag in the guts, in the groin, in the ribs, in the rump. I tell the poor fellow, Harry, my one cruel thumb exploded out his inward air and blew out the flare that he carried.
Great is this action!
Return of the fight!
If the situation is ripe for war,
how shall the onlooker judge between them?
One is a wrestler, strong and tough.
Yeah. Quick, the other one, deft in defensive throws and the back heel stuff.
Up from your places!
Into the ring again!
We must wrestle wit once more and fall upon foe! Fight him! Wrestle him!
Throw the book at him!
Talk to him!
Set on him!
Skin him alive!
Old tricks, new tricks, give him the works! This is the great debate for the championship! Have your own!
Never hold back anything for fear of
Now we've changed all that. They're good. And they're armed for action. Everyone's holding his little book so he can follow the subtle illusions.
And then you end, Blagar. The best in the world.
Yes, that's right. And sharp and ready for action.
Ready for you to begin.
Yeah. Here's your sophisticated audience.
Play it to win.
Yeah. All right. I'll go into your prologues first, since they happen at the beginning of every tragedy.
Right.
I will analyze this great man's prologues. Did you know how murky you were in getting your action underway?
Well, how are you going to analyze them?
Yeah.
Lots of ways. Let's start by reading the beginning of his Aristophanes.
Aristophanes!
Silence all! Let no man speak!
Archimedes, read. Hermes, Lord of the Dead, who watches over the powers of my father, be my guide and stand by my claim. I have come back to my own soil. I have returned.
Oh, yeah!
Dozen, maybe more.
And the line is only three lines long!
Yeah.
And every line had a dozen things wrong with it!
Now, Aeschylus, silence! Or you'll be mulched in three lines of blank verse plus cost.
Mean I have to keep quiet for him?
That's my advice to you!
Yeah. Made one colossal howler right in the beginning.
Did you hear that? You are crazy!
That has never bothered me much. Yeah.
What kind of mistake?
Start from the beginning.
Hermes, Lord of the Dead, who watches over the powers.
Okay, now let's see. This is where Orestes is talking over the tomb of his father. And his father's dead, that right?
That's right.
Now let's get this straight. This is where its father's been killed.
Murdered!
By his own wife in a treacherous plot. You have him saying that Hermes is watching over this?
I don't mean the Hermes you mean.
Yeah.
He was talking to the gentle lord of the underworld. He made that clear when he said he was keeping his inheritance for him.
Well, that was a bigger and better blunder than I'd hoped. He makes his inheritance an underworld property.
Hey, you mean Orestes would have to rob his father's grave?
You know, the wine you were drinking had bouquet. It stunk.
Read us another line. Euripides, you keep watch for errors.
Who watches over the power of my father's. Be my guide and stand by my claim. I have come back to my own soil. I have returned.
Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah.
The great Aeschylus has said the same thing twice.
Twice,
Let's look at this line again. Better yet, I'll show you. I have come back, you have said. But also, I have returned. I've come back means the same thing as I have returned.
You're right, my God! It's like saying to your neighbor, lend me your kneading trough. Your trough for kneading things.
Oh, you two jabberwocks, the two are not the same at all. The diction is excellent.
Well, show us.
Coming back means getting home, arriving with no further contacts. If he gets there, he arrives. The exile arriving comes back, but he also returns.
Good, by God! Well, what do you say?
I say Orestes did not return if return means restore.
He
snuck past the guards. It wasn't formal.
That's good. Except I don't know what you mean.
Come on, read another line.
By thy mountain grave bank, I entreated my hero to hear, to listen.
Same thing twice again. Hear, to listen, same thing twice again.
But he has to, you fool. He's talking to the dead.
Yeah.
We called to them three times and we still don't get through.
How do you make your prologue?
I'll give you some. And if you catch me saying the same thing twice or padding my lines without adding to the sense, spit in my eye. Not yet!
Because some lines then speak them. There's nothing else for it but to listen to your prologues and criticize the verse.
Oedipus at the outset was a fortunate man.
My God, he was not fortunate. Why, he was unfortunate from birth. Before birth,
because Apollo had prophesied that he would murder his own father. You think that at the outset is fortunate?
But then he became the wretchedest of humankind.
He did not become, he never stopped. Now look at this. When just after he was born, they put him in a broken pot and laid him out in the snow so he'd never grow up to murder his own father. Then he married an old lady who turned out to be his mother. So he went out and he blinded himself.
Which was the evil eye that he did in general, along with Aristophanes.
You're crazy. The prologues I write are very fine.
Yeah. I'll not savor your prologues line by line, word for word, but by the gods, I'll ruin them with a little bottle of oil. With a little bottle of oil. A packet of sheep. A bottle of sheep. By the way, you guys, prologues, there's just room enough for a phrase the length of this. I'll show you.
Show me.
I say I can do it.
Speak us along.
Aegyptus, as the common tale disseminates, and all his sea armada and his 50 sons coming to shore.
Little bottle of oil.
Yeah! A naughty little bottle, it'll be spanked for that. Give us another line, I want to see what happens.
Dionysus, who with Thrysis, and the hides of fawns appareled on Parnassus, up among the pines, dances on light feet.
I am struck again with a bottle of oil.
He hasn't done that much. I got plenty of prologues left, but he can't tag on any little bottle of oil. There's been no man who's had good fortune all his days, for one was born to fortune, but his goods are gone. One born unhappy.
Maybe you ought to strike your sound.
Demeter be my witness. It doesn't mean a thing. Here's the line to smash his little property.
All right, give us another. But look out for that bottle.
Cadmus, son of Agenor, once upon a time, sailing from Sidon.
His little bottle of oil.
My poor dear friend, you better buy that bottle quick before it chews up all your prologues.
Are you saying that I should buy from him?
That's my advice to you.
Well, I refuse to do it! I got plenty of prologues left where he can't tag on any little bottle of oil. Pelops, son of Tantalos, reaching Pisa, plain sailing from Sidon.
His little bottle of oil.
Fellow, he makes it work once again. Now, be a good fellow. It's not too late. For only a quarter, you can get one nice and new.
I won't do it. Here's another line for him. Aeneas, from his land.
Lost his little bottle of oil.
Wait a minute! Let me get Aeneas, from his land, choosing from his source of rain, and sacrificing.
In love his sacrifice. Who found it for him?
Oh!
Here's a line for him. Zeus has the most authentic version. Half main thing.
I wonder what charge he can make good against the great master of tragic verse. He courts disaster.
I fear for his sake.
Wonder is right if his prosody is what you mean. You'll see. One little cut and his meters all come out the same.
Well, give me a handful of pebbles. I'll keep the count.
Abo!
Ready? Thian, Achaean. As you hear in the slaughter of heroes, oh, what a stroke come you not to the rescue. Hurries ancestral, oh, how we honor you. We of the wayside, oh, what a stroke come you not to the rescue.
That's two strokes scored against you, Aeschylus.
Greatest Achaean Atreus. Sun ward, lord of multitudes, hear me, ho, what a stroke of you, not to the rescue.
Another stroke, your Aeschylus, that makes the third.
Quiet all, oh, beekeepers, now open the temples of Artemis nearby. Ho, what a stroke of you, not to the rescue. I am unable to sing of the prodigy shown at the wayside. Ho, what a stroke of you, not to the rescue.
Oh, what a mess. Stroke upon stroke has got my kidneys black and blue. I think I'll go take a cool, soothing bath.
Yeah. Wait till you hear my lines for the melodic verse. We shall now move to verses written for the lyre.
Very well, but leave out the strokes, if you please.
How the twin throne power of Achaea and manhood of Hela, de-tum-de-tum-de-tum-de-tum-de-tum, sends forth the Sphinx who is princess of ominous hellhounds, de-tum-de-tum-de-tum-de-tum-de-tum. Hand on the spear and in battle, the bird of encounter, de-tum-de-tum-de-tum-de-tum-de-tum, giving assault there to the hovering hounds of the airwaves, de-tum-de-tum-de-tum-de-tum-de-tum.
Where did you get this costume? Woohoo! Sounds like water pulling up from the well.
My sources are excellent. If you want to know, my results are too. I only did not want to be seen using the same meadow muse that Predicus uses. This man draws from all sources. Burlesque, Melodus, Greek and ditty, all that carrion jam, threnodies, and folk singing. Wait, I'll show you. No, here, give me something. No, don't use a lyre on that stuff. Where's that girl who uses oyster shells for castanets? Hither, European, Euripidean muse. To thee, only begetter of these mysteries.
So that's the tent muse. Well, she ain't no Sappho. That's a man's woman, if I ever saw one.
I'll send birds when the sea's ever screaming, bellows twittering, double wings from the flying spray, dipping and ducking, feathery forms, you and the angels under the roof, finger weavy, heaving in battle, handiwork of your woof-warp webs, singing shuttles endeavor, where the flute-loving dolphin leaps next to the cutwater's darkened edge. A wrangler in her posture, gleam and join the big box, where clusters of heart keys click and click. Circle me in your arms, oh my child. Listen to that line.
I'm listening.
Look at that one.
I'm looking.
You're the writer of lines like that. Dare to say that the verse is bad?
Oh.
Yours is made like a horror displayed in all the amorous postures. So much for your choral meters. Now I'll demonstrate the composition of your lyric meters. Oh, darkness of night, shining in gloom, but vision of dream bring you. Or me, fish from the occult depths, envoy of Hades. spiritless, spirit-possessing, child of the stable night, ghastly, grim apparition and dark trappings of death, blood is lovely, glaring, her nails were long, they were long. Help me, my handmaidens, light up the lanterns and run with your pitchers, fetch from the river and heat up the water, that I may wash this vision from me. Oh, spirit of the sea, that was it. My whole housemates, behold here our portents. Ye has stolen my rooster away, and lo, she is gone. For ye nymphs of the mountains made me arrest her. Soft you now. I was sitting, plying my humble task, at the loom filled with its glass. Wee hee 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 hee, with my hands spinning a veil so I could take it at dawn to market. And he fluttered away on gossamer wings in the air. And sorrow, sorrows he left me, and tears, tears from my eyes. Seizure, bows, and comes to aid me. With you, Dick Tennant, Artemis' pretty child, holding her puppies in leash, let her search your premises, and you, Zeus' daughter, both hands upholding your brightest twin torches, a pyro hanging at Glee's house, that I may get her with the gods by ravished rooster.
That will be all for the lyric verse.
Yay! Yay! Yay!
I have had enough. I want to bring them out and put them on the scales. That's the only way we can find a poem's true weight. Weigh it verse by verse, phrase by phrase, for specific gravity.
Then bring out the scales.
Scales!
My duty is to judge two master poets like a grocer selling cheese.
Scales!
Stevie is just a great animal.
Who could have thought of this but he? Had anyone else proceeded to such an invention, I would have said he needed medical attention.
Now, both of you, take your places by the way, Penn.
Ready?
Ready.
Hold your lines as you speak them. Don't drop them until I say cuckoo.
We have.
Say a line and lay it on the scale.
How I wish the Argos had never winged her way.
River Smericus with the cattle pastures near.
Cuckoo!
How can this be?
He put a river in it, the wool merchants drink, and soaked his words in water as they do their wool. But you put in a winged word, a feathery line. Wait a minute.
Match us again. Yeah. Have him speak another line.
Very well. Take your next line.
Ready.
Ready.
Speak them.
Persuasion hath no temple except within
the word. Death is the only god that is not moved by gifts.
Cuckoo!
Yeah!
Has the weight once again. He put in death. There's nothing more depressing than that.
But I put in persuasion. That's a handsome word.
Oh, persuasion. She's a featherweight, a scatterbrain. Better see if you can't turn up a line with more heft. Something massive and bulky to give you more weight.
Damn, where'd I put those lines like
this? We'll try this one. Achilles shot the dice and threw a deuce in a four. Oh, well, anyway, take your lines. This is the final test.
His right hand seized the spear, heavily shod with steel. Ooh.
Chariot piled upon chariot, corpse upon corpse.
Cuckoo!
Yeah!
I tricked you again.
How?
He threw in a couple of chariots and two dead bits. 100 Egyptian coolies couldn't lift that load.
All right, we'll not do it line by line anymore. No. Put him up on the scale with his children and his wife, Kephephazon, and then all his books piled in his lap. And I'll recite but two verses, and still I will sink the scale! No.
My friends! I cannot judge them anymore. I must not lose the love of either one of them. One of them is a great poet.
Yeah.
I like the other one.
Yeah.
You mean you won't do what you came down here to do?
And if I do decide,
then take the one you want and go. We must not let your journey be in vain.
Bless your heart.
Yeah.
Very well. I came down here to get a poet. Why? To help our city survive so it can stage my courses.
Okay.
The one of you who has the best advice for saving the city is the one I'll take back with me. Alcibiades is a baby who's giving the state delivery pains. What are we to do with him? That's the first question.
How does the state feel about him?
It calls for him. It hates him! It wants him back. Now give us an opinion, both of you. What are we to do?
I hate the citizen who, by nature, well endowed, is to himself useless to the community, is helpful to himself, to the community, is harmful.
What do you say, Estes?
We should not let a lion cub into the state. Lions are dangerous and they should never be there at all. But if we do let one in, then we must do as it desires.
By Zeus the Savior, I still can't make up my mind. What answer was so clever? The other one was so clear.
Let's go with clear.
Give me one more opinion, both of you. How can we save the city?
Give Cleocritus Kinesius to act as wings. Let him be airborne over the vast sea's expanse.
Well, that would be amusing. Would there be some point?
Armed with vinegar jars, he could bomb the enemy with vinegar in their eyes.
The chopper, not the vinegar! Vinegar!
I know what I'm talking about.
Vinegar!
Let me speak!
Speak!
One that we trust not now, we trust. And yet, we trust no more what we do trust. We shall win.
How's that again? Please, be a bit more stupid so I'll understand.
Stupid!
Now we trust, and trust no more, and use those citizens that we do not use now. We shall survive. If we are losing, using what we are losing. Might it not follow that we might win by doing the opposite?
Ingenious! Oh, my Palamedes, soul of wit! Did you think that up yourself, or was it Capisapod?
All by myself! The vinegar was Capisapod's.
What's your opinion?
Tell me, what kind of man is Athens choosing? Her best?
Her best? Where have you been?
She hates them like poison.
You really think that Athens likes her worst men?
Doesn't like them, uses them because she has to.
How shall we pull a city like that out of the water if neither the coarse cloak nor the smooth mantle will serve?
Well, you better find something quicker. She'll sink and never come up.
I'd rather not tell you that down here. I'd rather tell you that up there.
Oh, yes, please. Send your blessings up from underground.
She will win if she regards all her land as though it were her enemies, and her enemies as though it were her own. That all her ships are wealth. And all her wealth.
Good! But the jurymen will eat up all that well.
Decide!
Out of their own mouths have they spoken it. For I shall choose the poet that my soul desires.
Remember the vow you swore by all the gods to take me with you. Choose he who loves you best.
My mouth swore. My heart did not. I'm taking Aeschylus.
Can you do this and look me in the face for shame?
What's shameful? Unless it seems so to the audience.
Shameful.
Wilt thou leave me thus for dead? Say nay.
Nay.
Who knows? one more, so that we may beat you before you sell away. Oh, good news! I am not discontent with my morning's work.
Blessed he who has such wisdom and wit!
Many can learn from this.
Through good counsel, he won the right to return home again.
For the good of the cause and state, for the good of his fellow man.
To help them fight the good fight with his great frame.
Do not get us to beat of Socrates and chatter.
Nor cast out of the heart the high serious matter of tragic art.
Better not to compete in this no good, lazy, Socratic dialogue in this humble heat.
That is crazy!
Go all inside now, Nanak. Go forth rejoicing, Aeschylus. Go! Save us our city by your consent and integrity. Instruct the foolish majority. Here is a rope to get clear of. Here is a rope for the revenuers, Mamnak and Nicodemus. Give this to Archaean Numbers. Tell them that their line has come, that they are waiting for here today. And if they delay, I, in person, will brand them, sting them, sling them all to the bottom of the pit of Hades, where they belong.
Yeah. Here is my chair of tragedy. I will leave it for Sophocles until I come back down again to claim it, for he is the greatest of all poets except for me. But never leave it to that
him, and with his own sons and daughters, he likes him, as you escort him away.
First, O Eurydice, daughter of the throne dethroning, we pray you, grant fair journey to the poet as he goes back to the daylight.
Grant him success in all thoughts that will prosper our city.
So let
the Eurydice surcease from sorrows we suffer through wars and counters. Let we upon and all similar aliens who love to fight, go home and fight in the land of their fathers.
Thank you.
missing frog. No, it's the frog. It's a frog.
Yes, it's on, it should be on the program, I think.
Yeah, it's in the program.
Oh,